Hi everyone, my name is Aditya and I'm a developer evangelist at Salesforce. In this quick tip, I'm going to show you how you can deploy and host your Lightning Web Conference open source apps on GitHub Pages. In case you're wondering how to create the app in the first place, then check out my previous quick take linked in the description below. Let's get started. GitHub Pages is a static site hosting service that takes files straight from your GitHub repo to create a website. These files include HTML, JS, CSS, images, basically anything that's static and can be rendered on the client side. So that means you can't run server-side logic like Node.js scripts or PHP with GitHub Pages. There are three places from which GitHub Pages can pick static files to serve out websites: the root of the main branch, or the GitHub Pages branch, or the docs folder on any branch. Where you store the files is totally up to you. But the first step is to generate these static files for our Lightning Web Conference open source app. Let's see how that is done. Here we are in our LWC OSS app, and let's go to package.json. Let's scroll down to the script section, and here you'll find the build script. This is the one that creates a production build based on the bundler you have chosen during project creation. It can be either Webpack or Rollup. And this production build process is the one that generates the static files for us. Let's run the script. Once the script is run, you can see a new folder with the name dist is created, which contains all the transpiled files. So here you have the HTML file and two JavaScript files. All your web components, the LWC engine, third-party libraries you use are bundled into these JavaScript files. The resources folder holds your images and icons. These are the files that you can then host and run your app on any platform. If you are deploying this to a PaaS application like Heroku, you would also need to use the serve script in package.json, which essentially creates a simple Express server to serve this build output. But since GitHub Pages itself is a hosting service that can serve static content by itself, it doesn't need this Express server. So we won't be needing the serve script here. So now we have our files ready. The transpiled files are present in the distribution directory, and the source files are pretty much everything else. You can just push your transpiled files to GitHub, or if you really want to open source your project, you can push both the source files and the transpiled files. Here are a couple of options you have. The first one, you can push your transpiled files to the root of the main branch. You would typically use this to, let's say, create your personal website or create a blog or pretty much any site that you want to host using LWC OSS. You would generally prefer this method. The second and third options can be really useful if you want to open source your projects. That means both your source files and transpiled files go on GitHub. In the second option, you push all of your source files onto the root of the main branch and your transpiled files to the root of the GHPages branch. The third option is to push both your source files and the transpiled files to the same branch, main, but then the transpiled files go into the docs folder. So these are only some of the options. You have various permutations and combinations that you want to use based on what you're trying to do. But as I mentioned earlier, GitHub Pages can serve content from the root of the main branch or the root of the GitHub Pages branch, which is what options 1 and 2 are doing. And it can serve out the files from the docs folder on any branch, which is what the third option is doing. Let's look at some of these in action. First, let's create a GitHub repo. Make sure it is public, because if you want to create GitHub Pages on private repos, you need to upgrade to the pro plan on GitHub. You need not add any of these and just create the repository. Here are the list of commands that you need to execute in order to push your code to GitHub. Let's run them. So, because we want to push the contents only of the distribution directory, let's move to that directory. Now, let's execute these commands. Git init, then git add dot to add all the files, git commit to commit all of this code to the repo, then add the git remote URL as the origin, and finally push the code. Now we go back and refresh this page. And you can see that your code from the distribution folder is now pushed into the main branch. And now to enable GitHub Pages, go to Settings and scroll down to the GitHub Pages section. So here you can see it asks you to choose the source. Let's choose the main branch. And we say it's the root of the main branch. And then let's click Save. And this begins your deployment process. And in just a while, you'll see that your GitHub Pages has been successfully deployed. You can just click the link here and see the LWC app in action. And you can also verify that it is being served from github.io, which is what GitHub Pages uses to serve out web pages. Now, this is a process if you would want to deploy apps and you don't want to share the source code with everyone else. But what if you want to share the source code as well? As I mentioned earlier, you have two options. One is that you can push your source code to the main branch, and then the transpiled files can go into the GitHub Pages branch. Or you would want to push both of them to a single branch, main, and have the transpiled files in the docs folder. The approach is up to you, but in this quick take, let's look at the docs folder approach, because I want to show you a few things. So let's go back to our repository. In the folder structure, you can see we have all of our source files and the distribution folder. But now we need our transpiled files to be in a folder that is called docs. So one thing we can do is, of course, once you have run your build command, just rename this dist to docs and you can deploy it. But there's a more elegant way of doing it. If we go and look at package.json, what you can see is the build script leverages LWC services. And LWC services has a config file that lets you configure a bunch of stuff, ranging from the port number on which the development server runs, the build directory, resources, and much more. You can find all of that list by clicking this link over here. What you can see here is a list of all the settings that you can pass to LWC services. Most importantly, the build directory. So let's copy that and paste it into our LWC services config. And what we need to do here is rename dist to docs. And if you look at resources, they're going to go from SRC resources to dist resources. We need to rename this also to docs. And now save it. Let's run the build script now. And what you can see now is it creates a folder with the name docs. If you expand that, you can see all of the same contents. So now all you need to do is push all of this folder to a new GitHub repository, because the previous one that we have created, we've already pushed code to it. So let's create a new repo and then push the source files and the docs folder to it. I'm going to name it a little bit differently by appending docs to the name and leave the same settings as before and just create the repo. And now, as usual, follow all of these steps. And this time we are going to be running those on the project folder itself and not the docs folder, because we need both the source files and the docs folder to be deployed. I've now deployed the code and we can refresh this page to look at the output. So here you can see that all the source files have been committed along with the docs folder, which contains the transpiled files. Now we follow the same process to enable GitHub Pages. But this time we're going to choose the docs folder and save. And that's it. That's all the information you need to deploy to GitHub Pages. So what's next? You can actually automate the process of running the build script and committing the resultant transpiled files to either the branch or the folder using GitHub Actions, pre-commit hooks, or the GH Pages library. And that's about it for this quick take. Thank you for watching. If you've learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and click that bell icon to get notifications.